everyone, and welcome inside Alumni Arena. I'm Mike Bunt, and I'm excited to preview the upcoming season of UB basketball for Bullet Point. Buffalo's coming off an interesting COVID season in which they made the NIT for just the second time in school history, but expectations are much higher entering 2022. Jim Weitzel enters his third year as head coach, and he has a tremendous senior class led by the likes of Josh Mbalaj and Nathan Williams and Rondo Sagu. I spoke to them to see why they're the most dangerous trio in the Mid-American Conference.
Well, each one of them has a great talent. I always say they have a sharp sword.
Jonathan Williams, Rondo Sagu, and Josh Mbala play three completely different positions on the court, but there's one thing that unifies them.
Hard work. I mean, I put in hours in the gym. I work out every day. I don't take no days off. I don't take no shortcut.
We all been pushing each other to our limits to better each other, help each other out. The expectation is just to go out there, compete at a high level, play blue collar.
It's what they do behind the scenes. They work hard. Like, they probably the two hardest workers I ever played with. So that's what makes them different.
What also separates them is their skill on the court. Mbala is a double-double machine who gets it done on both sides of the ball, averaging 15 and 10 last year. Williams is a nightmare for opposing defenses with his ability to slash to the basket, while Sagu is one of the most electric players with the ball in the country.
Josh is an outstanding rebounder and defensive player. Jonathan's a very good scorer. Rondo can be one of the best playmakers in this league on a daily basis. All those kids are capable of scoring a lot of points, but can they sharpen their sword?
If they can, this Bull squad has the ability to reach their lofty goals.
I'm super excited, especially this is my last year, so you know I want to finish it the right way, which is with a MAC championship.
My goals is just to win games, win the MAC championship, and get to the NCAA tournament and make it to the Sweet 16.
Buffalo is becoming accustomed to playing in the postseason. They've made either the NCAA tournament or the NIT in five of the past 7 years, but haven't made it to the big dance since Nate Oates was in charge in 2019. With that in mind, I spoke to Coach Weitzel to see if he's feeling the pressure to get UB back into the NCAA tournament.
If I'm worried about the pressure, then it's going to be counterproductive. I'm not going to do my job.
Coach Weitzel blocks out the outside noise when it comes to his basketball program. At 36-21 and 23-12 in MAC play, he's off to one of the best starts in UB history. But that hasn't come without critics. Taking over a program that made the NCAA tournament in four of their previous five seasons comes with high expectations, something Weitzel enjoys.
I want to embrace the success we've had since I've been here. I don't feel the pressure. I think it's like the great challenge. I mean, I think that
let's go.
Perspective is basketball. I'm incredibly fortunate to coach these guys. I'm appreciative, but along with it, it's like, hey, let's go for the goal.
It's a viewpoint he shares with his team as they focus on the things they can control.
Let's march forward. And I think that's what we worry about. I mean, pressure, a lot of that's self-inflicted. I mean, you know, you got to be able to handle that, but if I can keep that perspective with our guys, then we should have fun during the season. That's still basketball. Let's just have a good time. Practice should be fun, and competing should be fun.
Most outlets have UB as the MAC favorites heading into the season. The mid-major top 25 has Buffalo as the sixth best mid-major in the entire country, while the MAC coaches poll has the Bulls winning the conference. There's no doubt many people expect Buffalo to be an active participant in March Madness for the first time in 3 years. With that in mind, I spoke to our Bullet Points expert, Kevin Masseri, to get his thoughts.
You would expect nothing less than 20 wins in this schedule. 20 games in the MAC play, pretty decently hard out of conference schedule here with 10 games. But, you know, they're playing in Cancun. They're playing mostly road games. You would have liked to see a home game here of big stature. But if you really add all that up, you're probably looking at a record prediction, 22-8. That's about where you're at right now going into postseason play. You're expecting an NCAA tournament berth. That's what you're expecting. Your favorite, your top 60 team. You're just voted as the sixth best mid-major in a few polls. So, you know, right now, that's nothing short of an NCAA tournament, probably more similar to those early Oates years of maybe a 12 or 13 seed, something along those lines. That is in the tournament expectations. And that's kind of my postseason prediction. I do think they get through the MAC finally and earn Jim Weitzel his first head coaching berth to the NCAA tournament in D1 at least. So that's what my expectations here for the postseason. How far do they go in the tournament? They could surprise a team. We've seen the MAC do it in the past, you know, almost every year now. You seem to see the MAC win a game at least. So, I think that's the full go. I don't think there's enough meat on the bone to be a an at-large bid in this schedule. They'd have to really come out of the gates firing. They need that at Michigan game, you know, right in your first game of the year. You'll know right then and there if this team is even in contention for an at-large bid. But that's what you're looking at, that at Michigan game. That's why that game's important. Like, no, for no other reason, you can tell right away, can you catch a sixth-ranked Michigan team sleeping on November 10th? You know, a senior heavy team is not going to be a super duper easy challenge for Michigan, the Wolverines there. So you're looking at a postseason berth, and you're looking at, you know, once again, 22-8 to get this stuff done, and to really rise maybe to a Ken Pom 50th overall team. That's kind of what you're looking for. And that's the expectations.
Kev, I think that's quite fair. For me, in order for this to be a successful season, Buffalo has to make the NCAA tournament. You take a look at their roster and what they're going to be losing after this year, the time to strike is now or never. With that in mind, Kev, what are some of the youngsters or newcomers that you think could emerge on the squad in 2022?
You've got a couple of players across the board that, you know, you really do have some roles here. You've got Maceo Jack, another senior, a one-year senior coming in, Coach Jack's son. What's Kidrell Blocker, a guy from Rochester who could come in with pretty high, you know, pretty highly regarded here. So I'd like to see what he's all about. You know, Curtis Jones, a freshman from Indian Hills Community College with pretty high regard. Zakir Williamson, another forward freshman that could add to the mix. Khalil Madding, a forward freshman that could add to the mix. There is Ty Perry, a junior, another newcomer into the system who will be here next year as well. So, there's a lot to look forward to from these youngsters. It is a fairly deep roster. Which one of those guys shows up? Is it, does, you know, highly regarded Zakir Williamson, our Kidrell Blocker, play big minutes? Khalil Madding, a pretty highly regarded 6'9 freshman. I don't know. Does he redshirt? There's questions that we'll need to see answered in the next couple of days.
We had our first chance to see the Bulls in action last week when they cruised to a 105-54 victory over Madai. The usual stars stepped up with Jonathan Williams and Josh Mbala leading UB with 19 points apiece. Rondo Sagu dished out 5 assists with Maceo Jack and Brock Bertram rounding out the starting lineup. Jack looks sharp and should be a solid addition for the Bulls. He's tall, athletic, and has a decent shot from deep. Bertram looks like he'll get more minutes this year, pulling down 10 rebounds in his season debut. The big story from their early practices is their depth and quality minutes coming off the bench. JUCO transfer Curtis Jones was the first guard off the bench on Thursday. He has some jump to his game and looks like he'll be a valuable player. He's joined by Coastal Carolina transfer Keyshawn Bruden, who's looking to make a bigger impact in his second season at UB after averaging 5.9 points per game last year in 12 games. Fordham transfer Ty Perry has a little bit of Dante Carruthers in him as he looks to add energy to Buffalo's rotation. Freshman Kidrell Blocker is raw but extremely athletic. He had a huge dunk late in the game against the Mavericks and looks to have a bright future. At forward, Trevon Fagan and Laquil Hardnett should continue to be quality role players. Next to them, there's some promise in David Skogman and Khalil Madding. Skogman is going to get more minutes this year. He's a strong three-point shooter and physical enough to pull down boards, grabbing 10 rebounds against Madai. Madding is very intriguing. He's 6'9", has a huge wingspan, and was a force defensively against the Mavericks, recording multiple blocks while impacting shots. He's also shown some offensive awareness with a monster putback slam, which made SportsCenter's top 10 plays. This Buffalo squad is well-rounded, they're athletic, physical, have decent length, move the ball well, and have the ability to slash to the basket and post up. It's all there for them to have a big year. Now, Kev, we spoke to Coach Whitesell earlier in the show to see if he's feeling the pressure to make the big dance. We've both been critical of him in the past. Do you think this is a make-or-break year for him?
There is pressure mounting on Jim Whitesell. Now, is it fan pressure? Is it actual university pressure? You know, that's tough to say. You know, if you really look at it, he mounted a pretty good end of the season last year, minus the two final games that they played. They kind of turned it on late, you know, winning 7 straight there. They kind of struggled prior to that 7-game stretch after a loss to Toledo at home, 80-70, 9-7 in MAC play. You know, that was the tipping point around February there. 9-7 overall, 7-5 in the MAC. You know, that was a really big moment of like, where are they going to go here with this? And they did end up railing off 7 straight wins before losing, you know, having two poor performances there. You know, it's just all in the eye of the beholder for Jim Whitesell, 36-21 as UB head coach. 23 and 12 in MAC play. You know, the numbers are there historically, but not for what he took over. These are still players that he kept from Nate Oates's Alabama. Now recently the Alabama head coach. This is what we're after right now, though. This is the make or break year. Will it actually break? Not unless it's really, really poor. However, this is a really important season. I mean, this is what you saved. This is what you built up for, you know, top 60 team everywhere, top 50 team everywhere. You know, this is the season that you built up, you know, your last couple of years, and to get acclimated in, to keep your players. It was a big selling point here. So I do think that the pressure could mount if you start to see some things go south at times, especially during MAC play in a not particularly strong MAC. I'm sure a team will come out of nowhere, but a not particularly strong MAC team, overall MAC competition wise. It's always a good conference. You're adding two new teams to it at some point here in Western Kentucky, who, you know, randomly enough, they'll be playing. And then Middle Tennessee State University, you know, straight up where Antoine Johnson came from, a former player at UB. So there is going to be, it's going to be tougher here soon. So, you know, this is the season you need to get it done.
Kevin, I appreciate the input. Before we wrap up the show, let's take a look at our bullet point predictions for the season.
Let's get started with Rob Ryan. He has Buffalo going 24-7 overall and 15-5 in conference play, winning the Mid-American Conference Tournament to return to the Big Dance for the first time in 3 years. He has Jonathan Williams as team MVP and Keyshawn Bruden as the most improved. Ty B, one more win in conference play, one less overall, going 23-8 and 16-4, winning the MAC tournament to go back to March Madness. Jonathan Williams, another vote for team MVP, with freshman Cottrell Blocker getting the top newcomer award coming out of Rochester. Kevin Masseri, we already heard what his predictions are, 22-9 overall. He has Buffalo going to the NCAA tournament. Williams, another MVP vote. His top newcomer, Maceo Jack, the son of UB Women's head coach, Felicia Legit Jack, and most improved player being Keyshawn Bruden. And let's continue it with Maniac. He actually has UB finishing second in the conference, but getting back to the NCAA tournament, team MVP, by now we know, Jonathan Williams, top newcomer, Maceo Jack. Maniac loves Felicia Legit Jack and thinks her son is going to have a prominent role on this Bulls team this season. And finally, my turn. I have UB going 24-7 and 15-5 in MAC play, making it back to the NCAA tournament after winning the MAC regular season crown. The Big Dance is a necessity for this squad. They have one of their most talented senior classes in program history, featuring their highest-ranked recruit to ever play at UB in Jonathan Williams. Ohio and Toledo pose some challenges, but UB has the top-end talent and depth to not only be the best team in the MAC, but be one of the best mid-major programs in the country. I love their schedule, featuring games against two ranked opponents at Michigan and St. Bonaventure, as well as a future MAC member in Western Kentucky and defending Conference USA champion North Texas. Upset the Bonnies, and it could be a special season. Well, folks, I hope you enjoyed our UB basketball season preview show. You could follow us at bulletpoint716 and Mike_Bunt. Remember, this stampede never stops.